Welcome to a lesson on determining the perpendicular bisector of a segment on the coordinate plane. Here we see a red perpendicular bisector of the blue segment on the coordinate plane. Remember, that tells us two things. First, this red line cuts a segment into two congruent segments, or two segments that have the same length. So this segment here is the same length as this segment here. And the second thing is that the intersection of the line and the segment form a right angle. So this angle right here is a right angle and therefore measures 90 degrees. And in fact, all four of these angles would be right angles. So the goal of this video is to determine the equation of this red perpendicular bisector given a segment on the coordinate plane. So in order to do this, there are two main things that we have to do. Number one, if we determine the midpoint of the segment, notice it'll give us one point on the perpendicular bisector. And the second thing to remember is that if two lines are perpendicular, their slopes are negative reciprocals. Notice how the slope of this blue segment is positive 1, and the slope of the perpendicular bisector is negative 1. They're negative reciprocals of one another, and their product is also equal to negative 1. Let's go and take a look at an example. So here we want to determine the equation of the perpendicular bisector of the given segment. Let's start by determining the coordinates of the endpoints of the given segment. This point here would be negative 3, negative 4. This point here would be 5, 0. So the first step is going to be to determine the midpoint of the given segment. Remember, that's going to give us one point on the perpendicular bisector. So to determine the x-coordinate of the midpoint, we sum the x-coordinates and then divide by 2. So we'll have negative 3 plus 5 divided by 2. Then to determine the y-coordinate of the midpoint, we add the y-coordinates and divide by 2. So the x-coordinate of the midpoint is going to be negative 3 plus 5, that's 2, divided by 2, that's positive 1. And here we have negative 4 divided by 2, that's negative 2. The next thing we have to do is determine the slope of the segment, because the slope of the line is going to be the negative reciprocal. So the slope of the segment, we can either use the formula y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1, or we could try to pick two convenient points on the coordinate plane. I'm going to go ahead and review the formula. So it's y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So let's call these the ones and these the twos. So we'll have 0 minus negative 4 over 5 minus negative 3. So we'll have positive 4 over positive 8. So the slope of the segment is equal to positive 1/2. So the perpendicular bisector of this segment is going to pass through the point 1, negative 2. And the slope of the perpendicular bisector is going to be the negative reciprocal of 1/2. So if we flip this over and change the sign, we'll have negative 2 over 1, or just negative 2. So now we'll determine the equation of this line. Remember, to find the equation of a line given the slope and a point, we can either use the slope-intercept form, or we can use the point-slope form of a line. Let's go ahead and use the point-slope form of a line. So if we do this, our slope m is negative 2, x1 is positive 1, and y1 is equal to negative 2. So we're going to have y minus y1, that's minus negative 2, must equal the slope, negative 2, times x minus x1. So now we'll go ahead and solve this for y to put it in slope-intercept form. So we'll have y plus 2 equals negative 2x plus 2. Now if we subtract 2 on both sides, we have y equals negative 2x. So we have a slope of negative 2, and our y-intercept would be 0. Let's go ahead and graph that and see if it is the perpendicular bisector. Well, we have a y-intercept of 0 and a slope of negative 2. To graph it, we probably put negative 2 over 1. So if we go down 2 and write 1, notice we're at the midpoint, 1, negative 2 of the segment. So this does bisect it, and that line does form a right angle with the blue segment. So that is the equation of the perpendicular bisector, y equals negative 2x. I hope you found this example helpful.